Hello, ladies and gentlemen, Beaky here with the Untitled Game Show, back once again with another PlayStation 4 menu tip and trick. And of course, ladies and gentlemen, today we're going to do the big one, the PlayStation 4 3.5 Remote Play to PC update. You can now remote play your PlayStation 4 over to your PC on Windows PC or Mac. It's Windows 8.1 up to Windows 10 or later. Of course, guys, there are already a few hiccups, and I'm going to try to explain the process and the problems that you might encounter during this process. First thing first, though, guys, go ahead and download the software and install it. It will install to your C drive. After you've installed the software, go ahead and start it up. I'm going to start it up right here. It's going to ask you to connect and check for updates. Before you go any farther on this screen right here, go on your PlayStation 4 and do this. Go ahead and log into your PS4. Then you want to go over to the settings, because if this is not enabled, well, this is definitely not going to work for you. You want to go down to Remote Play Connection Settings, and you want to click right here where it says Enable Remote Play. This is a setting you might have never had enabled if you never intended to use Remote Play before with the PlayStation Vita or any other devices that have Remote Play functionality. So make sure you have that enabled, because this will not work without it. That's the first thing you need to do, because every other step before this is useless without it. Now, the next thing you could do with your PS4, you could go ahead and, this is just a tip for you guys because you might not know this, you might want to go down to your power settings and make sure these features are actually set to on. Not the supply power to USB. You want to stay connected to the internet, enable PS4 turn on from network. You want to have this on, so if you're far away from your PS4, you actually could remotely connect to your PS4 and turn it on over the network. These settings need to be enabled for the functionality to be turned on from reset mode. Now we'll go ahead and head back on over to the desktop. Now, at the desktop, there's a few things you could do. You could go into settings right here, and you could jump ahead one step and sign right into the PlayStation Network. This will make it easier instead of going into right to start. You could set your resolution. It's up to 360p. Standard is 540p, which seems really weird. And then there is high for 720p. Unfortunately, you can't go up to 1080p on this at the moment. So we're just going to go ahead and show you guys standard just to start off, even though I know my connection could take more of it. And you could go all the way up to high as well for 60fps, but standard is going to be 30, all right? Press OK, and we're going to head and connect our PS4 controller by the USB to the PC. Press Start. Now it's going to pop up to sign into my PSN network. I'm going to do that right now. All right, I was just signed in. Now it's going to try to search for my PlayStation 4 via the internet. If it recognizes my PlayStation 4 is on right now, which it is on, and it's going to try to connect. If my PlayStation 4 is in reset mode, then it will try to turn on my PlayStation 4 and then connect from there. If you guys can see right now, this is my PlayStation 4. It is on currently. Nothing's been happening on it, but here is the desktop as well. It's going to take a while to actually find the PlayStation 4 I find. So what I'm going to do for you guys, I'm just going to go ahead and time skip, because like it says, it may take a few minutes to find the PS4. It's taken up to 5 minutes before for this application to eventually find the PlayStation 4. So it's not a quick process to set it up the first time, but once it has been set up, it seems to be pretty quick to do it after that. All right, guys. And also, you can go ahead and register it manually if this is taking too long by putting in some information from your PlayStation 4 console, but we won't have to do that right now. But there are going to be some numbers and things we're going to have to enter into some boxes very soon. So just let this process out and it'll find the PlayStation 4 in due time. Just might take a few minutes. Okay, it's went ahead and found my PlayStation 4. That took about 3.5 minutes for the application to find the PS4. Once you sign in, it does take a while to actually find it. It's going to maybe even take longer if your PlayStation 4 is in reset mode. This is where it's going to actually tell you to get some information from your PlayStation 4. This is why when you're doing this for the very first time, you want to actually be very close to your console and don't do it from a long distance. You obviously could get this information after the fact and carry it around with you if you want to connect it to a laptop or to a computer at a different location, which is what I'm going to be doing this with, this because I'm going to be using this over the internet and not like just in my own home. So you want to go ahead into your settings once again, and you want to go to remote play connection settings. You want to go to add devices, and when you go to add devices, it's going to give you a long code, and then that code is what you're going to go ahead and type into this box right here. Whatever your code might be. I'm not going to show you guys my code personally, but you guys can know what you guys do. Just click here and get your code and then add that code in there. And then we're going to go right over to the next step. All right. After you went ahead and connected to the PlayStation 4, you will be all set to go. It'll bring you back to the remote play connection settings. And on your desktop, for me, the first time I get connected, this is the mention I always see. The connection to the PlayStation 4 has lost, and I just press OK. And once I do that, all I gotta do is press start again. Like I said, there's a few little bugs that I don't understand why it's like this. But I'm gonna try to explain certain things real soon. Just press start. And then it's going to work. I don't know why the first time you connect it, it automatically disconnects it. But there you go. Now it's going to try to connect to the PlayStation 4. And now you connect your PlayStation controller to the PC. And as you guys will be seeing, right now it is 540p. I am now being able to connect my control. And just like that, we're connected to the PlayStation 4. You can go ahead and start streaming your games directly to your PC. Rocket League, Yu-Gi-Oh, whatever it might be. Now, there are a few things to note, and I'm gonna try to go over them right now. For one, controller issues. If you're actually using a controller and you have any issues whatsoever, right guys, any issues at all, you need to make sure that you have a good data cable, meaning the PlayStation 4 original cable that came with your controller, that's the one to use, or a high quality cable that came with any one of your Android phones or Android devices. A cheap cable that's just meant to send power will not work. You can connect your PlayStation 4 controller via Bluetooth if you have Bluetooth on your laptop or PC. If you guys are wondering, can you use an Xbox One wireless controller? Well, not really. I'm going to go ahead and pick up my Xbox One wireless controller right now, and I'm going to go ahead and try to press, let's say, the home button. The best you could do is double tap the home button on the Xbox One controller. Let me show you this right now. And you will be able to bring up the little recording menu you see right there. So I actually could use the Xbox One controller to record gameplay right here on this application for the PlayStation 4, but it won't actually let me control the game itself. Now, if you guys are wondering if you could use a keyboard or mouse, well, the answer is actually yes. Here I am with the keyboard and mouse. I actually just press entered right there. It's different because I could pause the game. I could move forward right here. But you have to figure out what buttons control specific games, because that was my boost button I just pressed with escape. I could jump around using an enter button in Rocket League, but you're going to have to figure out what buttons actually correspond to a gamepad if you're going to be trying to use keyboard and mouse for games with the keyboard. It's just not everything works the same, but you can go ahead and use a mouse, as you guys see right here, and go ahead and press the option button to bring up options. You press the share button right there to take a picture. You press the PlayStation button, and if you're going to play a game maybe like Yu-Gi-Oh, like here I'm using the keyboard and mouse once again to go through these menus. Keyboard and mouse makes it very easy to go through the menus, and you can play certain games that are basically like card games. Like I can play a whole entire match of Yu-Gi-Oh just using the keyboard and mouse because it's very simple. All I gotta do is press enter, escape, stuff like that. So yes, you can play your PlayStation 4 games using keyboard and mouse. It just varies from title to title from my experience. So far my biggest issues have been basically control related, getting the controller synced to the PC. Besides that, everything else works great. Like I could go ahead and close out the application, reopen it right now, and one second, let me get rid of that game bar. And then we could go into the settings real quick, and we could go ahead and turn it up to 720p, high, press OK, press start, and then we're back connected to it, and as you guys see, and of course if I go over to my actual PlayStation 4 itself, here it's the PS4 itself. So this is what the PS4 is actually seeing from my capture card and my PC. Here's the PS4 view from actually on my desktop itself. So once again, I'm gonna make it full screen. So we're gonna switch back and forth live, right? This is my let me see if I could bring it so you can see the quality. Oh, sorry about the bar. The bar, I can't seem to get a way to get rid of the bar. But here we go. This is the PlayStation 4 streaming to my PC right there. This is the PS4 directly from the capture card. Capture card, PC. Capture card, PC. So let's go ahead and go with something more graphically intense, like Final Cut Primal. Then we'll be able to compare a little bit better between how the remote play actually shows up when it's something a little bit more heavy on gameplay. Because Far Cry Primal is one of those games that it just has so much foliage, is the technical word, I guess, and like so much stuff going on with the environment and the, you know, whole entire grass, trees, all that stuff, that it actually could make a kind of little difference in seeing it in 720p streaming, and I could try out the latency. So far from what I've tried, guys, because like I said, I tried before, latency is not a problem. Like, I've used stuff like, to me personally, guys, I've used OnLive. I had an OnLive account for years, and that was completely streaming games. I've used a PlayStation Vita, PlayStation Portable, remote play stuff. So I've gotten kind of used to it in a sense. Oh man, I'm only 4% in Far Cry Primal. I need to get a little better. So let's see if I can skip all this. Skip. Right there. So we're going to check out for latency right now. Now, guys, I can already feel it's not 100% one-on-one. Like, you know, like how it would be if you were playing it on directly on the PlayStation 4. But it's not bad. It's definitely not bad. Swinging my club around. There is a delay, guys. I can't lie that there's no delay. There is a delay. And it's kind of jarring in a game like this. But like I said, it's not the worst delay. It wouldn't stop me from playing the being able to play the game. Like, if I needed to, this is my own wolf, but if I needed to, that's kind of messed up. But if I needed to heal or just wanted to play this game, I could. Like, that's the thing. I could play it. Now, let me show you guys what it actually looks like directly from the capture card. In fact, let's go ahead and do a... See, it's so much better. Like, a game like this looks so much better from the capture card compared to the streaming version. You could clearly see it compared to the menus. Let's go full screen. So, like, look. Let me look at my wolf. Capture card, crystal, nice, clear. 720p is kind of grayed out. There's definitely a difference, guys. There's definitely a difference. And when you're playing with the capture card, so much, like right here, it's a lot more smoother for me. It looks better in motion. But when I'm playing with the, like, if you look at the leaves right here, now I'm going to switch back over to capture card. This is just basically the demonstration part. It's like grayed out a little. But like I said, playable. It is playable. I probably should do a full comparison video, like side by side. Like, I literally could just do it like this. So let's just skip through that. So at this point, this is just a demonstration part of the video. It's like nothing else to do with the rest. I know a lot of people probably gone by now. If anybody's watching at this point, just let me know. I was like messing around with the tech part of this stuff. So to me, this is actually kind of interesting. This is going to make it a lot easier for certain people to maybe capture gameplay, you know, a little better for using this system than using directly from the PlayStation 4. Like, if you don't have a capture card right now, right? Let's say this. You don't have a capture card in your PC. Like, to capture things over HDMI, Elgato, AverMedia, Razer. Razer just came out a new one. I can't remember what Razer's one's called. But whatever the Razer's one's called. If you don't have that right now, well, you could use this system to stream it to your PC and then capture it using any, like, free program. You could literally use it. Look, like I said, I'm pressing the Xbox One controller button right now. I could literally capture it using the Xbox One software. So let's see how we actually fare. Once again, guys, I will find out right now if the lag is going to be killer or not. On the right is the basically directly from my PS4 capture card. On the left is from the... Oh, shit, sorry. I'm not even paying attention to the game. All right, I should be telling you guys about like how it feels. So it's alright. It's not like, it's not as good as just me watching from the TV or even from the capture card, because even when I'm watching from the capture card, there's a little bit of delay. Anyways, let me switch characters, because right now this character... Well, actually, I want him to kick my ass in a way, just because I want to actually do something. Ooh, good fucking job. It doesn't feel right. Like, it doesn't feel 100% right for a fighting game. Like, I could tell when it slows down. Like, it's maybe because I'm doing the 720p, maybe I should have just did it to 540p, which is standard. Once again, this is high. All depends on your internet connection, what other people's on your internet connection trying to do. Like I said, I don't know if any of my family is streaming Netflix right now, which is something that it seems like they're always doing. Somebody's always, like, streaming Netflix or Amazon something, some streaming thing, or me on YouTube. So, that always uses up bandwidth and all that stuff. So, just be noted that it's gonna affect everything. And sorry that this match sucks, because I'm just like really focused on talking to you guys more than I am really paying attention to the game. Let me see. Left, right, left, right. I'm just trying to like, it's pretty responsive. Like, just feel, I'm looking at it right now. Like, I don't know. Let me know what you guys think. That's what it's all about, guys. Let me know what you guys think about it. So this is like a quick comparison of, you know, remote play, PC, and all that jazz. Just got a message on PlayStation. Oh, Faceless. Sorry, Faceless. I'm just making a video right now. So I'll talk to you later. I'll just let him know. I'll let him know real quick. And then call that a wrap-up video. Yo, Faceless, man. I'm making a video right now. Sorry. I'm done. I'm not sure if you can hear me.
Hey, I got the division.
Huh?
Oh, I got the division.
Yo, oh, sorry. Say that again one more time.
I said I have the division now.
Oh, yeah, nice.
Mario Llama,
nice stuff, man. What level you at?
30.
Oh,
I knew that nigga was level 30.
Damn, I'm not even near 30. I'm only level 20. I've been playing a little bit. I haven't played it that much. I've been playing like Fallout and other stuff. So, yeah. Yep. Alright, BK here with the Untitled Game Show. Hope you guys like this little more weird video from me. But I like doing stuff like this. A lot of hardware. That's kind of why I'm excited to get the HTC Vive. I like looking at the little weirder side of gaming when it comes to like the hardware stuff. These applications they put out that, you know, streaming PS4 to the PC. I know somebody out there is going to find a lot of use for this. And I already have my ideas of what I would use it for. I don't think it's like something I'm going to use in my home much. Like, I don't see any reason for me to use it, especially with my type of setup where I have like, you know, capture cards around and I already have a Vita if I wanted to do, but I don't do remote play on my Vita enough. Like, I've been thinking about starting to do that with the division, just like lay in bed and play the division, but I'm like, I don't want to lay in bed and playing video games. Like, it's something I'm like, man, that's the real ultimate like relax or laziness. That's not me. All right, let me stop rambling on. Peace out, ladies and gentlemen. Peace out. We'll be right back.